We do have one candidate unopposed, Judge Brian Hansford, and he's graciously agreed to say a couple of words. Yes, to thank us for not having anybody run this.
Thank you, Hatcher. Good evening, everyone. It's always strange to me that I stand in front of a courtroom of people most days and do this, and it's still different than standing in front of all of you. The first thing I'd like to say is I would like to just recognize and commend everyone who is up there tonight. I don't know if you've ever run for office or not, but it's a very arduous process for both the candidate and the candidate's family. And whether or not you agree with any of their respective positions, I hope that you share the same respect that I have for them for giving of themselves and of their time to engage in this process. So thank you. Thank you all for what you're doing. I've been given 2 minutes, so I just decided rather than talking about me, I wanted to tell you about your court. Your court is functioning very well right now. There are three particular initiatives I wanted to tell you about, and if you obviously can't expand on them in 2 minutes, but if you have additional questions, you can reach me by email or telephone, and I'll be glad to expand on them. Number one is we see a lot of the same people over and over again in our court who have mental health issues. And obviously, as a municipal court, we don't have the funding or the access to the same things the state and superior courts have to get those people the help that they need. So it becomes a cycle. And so what we've done is we've reached out to the Superior Court of Fulton County that actually has a mental health court, and we are forming a relationship with them so that we can take some of these cases in the right instances and pass those cases on to Fulton County so that these people can get into the mental health court and receive the services that that court can provide, both financial services and primarily treatment services, hopefully to end that cycle of recidivism. Secondly, we've got a new under 21 driver program that we are utilizing. Under 21 drivers in Georgia can't plead nolo contendere, which means they get points on their record and their parents' insurance goes up. So when we have under 21 drivers who come to court, if it's not excessive, the ticket's not excessive, and if they have a clean record, we have a program that we've implemented to help keep those offenses off their record, keep parents' insurance down, but also to hopefully educate them on better driving habits. So that's number two. Number three is a customer service attitude, which I know is strange for a court, but it's something I believe in. Practice in courts everywhere, every day when I'm not sitting on the bench. And I can tell you that a lot of courts don't treat people so well. It's intimidating. And we have a philosophy that people who come to court are our customers. And we could all wind up in the same situation, whether it's with a ticket or charged with an offense. So I have a rule that we treat everyone just like we treat our neighbor, and it's worked out pretty well so far. I think most people are happy with the way they're treated when they come to court. Nobody likes to come to court, but we like to make it as pleasurable as possible. Thank you for your time tonight, and I'll turn it back over to Hatcher.